So hello guys, welcome back to another video, and in this video we will see how to find command injection vulnerability. We will do a practical tutorial and we will do a live practical tutorial of command injection on DVWL app. So let's get into the video. So here we are on our computer screen. So first of all, we'll start from what is command injection. Okay, so let's get into the file and find the file OS command injection. Here it is. Now what is command injection? OS command injection, also known as shell injection, is a web vulnerability that allows an attacker to execute arbitrary operating system commands on the server that is running an application, and typically fully compromises the application and all its data. Very often an attacker can leverage an OS command injection vulnerability to compromise other parts of the hosting infrastructure, explaining trust relations and exploiting trust relationships to pivot the attack to the other system within the organization. So in simple language, so basically an OS command injection is to execute a command in the server of in the web app simply. So now what we need to do this is a browser to access the web and a burp suite. So now let me open my burp suite and a browser. Now here we are testing our command injection on DVWL app. So let me access the DVWL app. Let me click login. Yeah, here you can see we are in our DVWL app. Let me decrease the security to low. Now let me go to command injection here, and here is a function you can ping the IP. So let me just adjust the layout. Now let me set my proxy. Here the intercept is on. Let me turn it off. And then IP, let's say one. What is a random number? When I click on ping, it's loading. You can see in the top left corner it is trying to ping 1. So here you can see that the website, it has pinged the 1. So how can we find a command injection here? So here we are in our low security in DVWA. Let me see here. Yeah, okay. So now what we can do is, like, let me put a random IP. I'm not putting a random IP, I'm just putting 1, and this is the request you will get. Okay, so you can see that this is the type of request you will get, and we are on low security, so we will get a low security measure. So let's try to put some delimiters here. But first of all, what is delimiter? Delimiter is a type of some type of symbols. Let me show you, like some symbols like pipe, double end, semicolon, and other symbols. Okay, so there are a lot of delimiters. I will mention a link in the description so you can check it out. Okay, so we will try to put a basic delimiter there. So now what we'll do is just try to put a semicolon here. First of all, let me send it to repeater. Okay, now we'll try to put a semicolon and try to execute a command cat slash etc slash password. Yeah, now let me click on forward. We're just typing a command to just execute a command, which is cat, okay, and etc password. We just want to read the cat etc password. Now I forwarded the request. Now wait for it. So you can see that nothing happened here. So what we can do now, I just intercept the request again. Let me go to the ping section once again. Now let me put the same command after the IP section. IP equals to 1 semicolon space cat slash etc slash password. And now hit go. Not actually go forward. Now let me wait for it. You can see that it's loading the top left corner. Boom. You can see that we got the etc password here file. Not actually. We got the etc password file here. You can see that. So just we completed the low security measure section of command injection. So it's hard to get this type of command injection in the real life websites, because when you will get like in real cases, there are good measures for command injection. So now let's level up the security to medium. Let me click on submit. Let me go back to command injection section. Yeah, now let me try to do again. Let me try to ping again. Here we got the same type of request. IP equals to 1, submit equals to submit. Now we are just trying the old method again. Semicolon cat slash etc slash password. Let's wait for it. We got nothing. Now what you can do is, let's check the source code. It's loading actually. Oh wait, we forgot to turn off the intercept. Okay, now in the source code we can see that semicolon and double end are blocked. So now what we can do, a lot of other things. There are a lot of delimiters we can try. So let me close this one. Enter an IP again here. 1. Intercept on. Let me hit go. Here's the request. Now we will go to the IP section again. IP equals to 1. Now we are adding another delimiter, which is known as pipe. Okay, so this is the pipe. Let me put the pipe again. Yeah. Now let's execute the command. Cat slash etc slash password. Now let me go and wait for it. And here you can see that we got the etc slash password file here. Now we are again leveling up the security level. Now turn on the intercept. Now we are less leveling up the intercept. Okay, now let me go to the command section again. Command injection section, sorry. Now let's type 1 again. Oh wait, what's happening here? Yeah, let me type 1 again. We got the same kind of request. Now what? Let's try to do the same payload, semicolon cat slash etc slash password. Okay, now let me click forward. Now you can see that we got nothing again. So let's check the source code. So here you can see there is a lot of delimiters which are blocked. So what we can do is, we have a lot of other options too. So we'll try them too. So let me close this one. One, submit, intercept on. Oh wait, the intercept was off actually. One, intercept on, submit. Yeah, here we got the request. So what payload we will use here? As you can see, there are single pipe is blocked, double end blocked, semicolon blocked, and another payload are blocked. So we will use double pipe. Okay, oh wait. Yeah. Now after the double pipe, what we will do is, let me go back to the double pipe. Yes. Now let's type a command. Let's type the old command again. Cat slash etc slash password. Now let me hit forward. Okay, now let's wait for the command to execute. Okay, And here you can see that we got the ETCS password file. So we saw how command injection works on DBWA and how to exploit it. Now we are learning it on next level. So I'm going to the link and in the description, which is portsugal.net, and you have to complete this whole lab. It's really amazing. You will learn a lot of things about command injection. You will learn on like real case situations, and you will prepare for the real life situations for the OS command injection. As I can't show how to perform OS command injection on real webs because YouTube will block the content, but still, this is the best resource if you want to learn OS command injection. Okay, I think I have completed all the labs except one. So yeah, for the OS command injection, you can go there. Okay, and I also mentioned two other links in the PDF too. Let me go there. Yeah, there are two other links too. Okay, you have to visit them too. They are amazing Medium articles. You have to read them if you want to get started in OS command injection. You will learn a lot of about OS command injection from these two blogs. So this is for the video. Thanks for watching, and we are also launching some workshops and private bug bounty classes, live bug bounty classes, practical bug bounty classes, and other things. So you can follow us on Instagram. I will mention the link in the description. And if you want to enroll in the private courses, then you can DM us on Instagram. So this is for the video. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel.